Live from the Civic Media World Headquarters in Madison, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Albaugh Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Albaugh.
Across Wisconsin on the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming worldwide on the Civic Media app. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Todd Albaugh, along with our outstanding producer, Mr. Aaron Zommers, on the board. It is 6 past the hour of 12 noon on this Tuesday, September 17th, 2024. It is a great day to be a Wisconsinite high atop State Street, a block off the Capitol Square. Sunny skies, Mr. Zommers, sunny skies for this last full week of summer, at least by the meteorologists and the astrologers or whatever. Anyway, it's the September, you know, is for the start officially of autumn, but it feels like a beautiful summer day out there.
Yeah, although I will say less summery over by my house in that there's leaves all over the ground.
I know, right? And I remember when, I mean, you know, here goes old man Todd. You know, back when I was a kid, once you got to the middle of September, it was pretty cool out there and leaves were falling. And I think that's what, again, I don't want to get into a big discussion right now, but with undeniable climate change,
right
now you see these leaves turning colors and falling, but it's still a short weather. So, I mean, it seems a little odd.
Most definitely.
But hey, that's the world we live in. But we'll just enjoy it. We'll enjoy this nice weather. Again, we're going to be with you live from Cheese Days in Monroe. It looks like a spectacular forecast on Thursday and Friday. We're going to be down there on the square right at the courthouse, thanks to my great friend Rob Wheat and the great folks there in Monroe. We're going to be all set up. Matt Flynn is going to join us for a little bit, I think, each day. And we're going to have a lot of local people. We'll have accordion players. We'll have yodelers. We'll have cheese makers. And we'll have cheese. How about that?
What more can you ask for?
What more do you want?
You can't beat it with a stick.
No, you cannot. As Ken Lewis is fond of saying, can't beat it with a stick. So we'll be down there in Monroe and looking forward to that on Thursday and Friday of this week. Tomorrow, our old friends Trigvi Olson of the Lincoln Project and Pat Kreitlow will join us for a little midweek edition. Normally on Tuesdays, we would have our friend Luke Mathers for a little What's grinding Luke's gears, a Tuesday tangent, but Lukester was unable to get a signal from the greater European area.
However, I don't think he tried.
He did not.
He's on vacation.
He's on a well-deserved vacation. Luke will be back with us very soon. So, but we have a busy, busy show, lots to get to today, but I want to start real quickly. Mr. Zommers, you saw this great new movie, Just a Bit Outside, the story of the 1982 Milwaukee Brewers. I still have my wristband on here that was our ticket in for the night that I went. And it's a great reminder because the reviews are in, Mr. Zommers. The reviews are in on Rotten Tomatoes. If you've never heard of that, it's an online rating system. And the movie has 50-plus ratings, all 5-star. It's a 100% review on Rotten Tomatoes, nearly unheard of. And here's the interesting. We just got this data in from the U.S. box office per screen average for last weekend. And so it's per screen average. Just a Bit Outside, only showing on 14 screens in Wisconsin, number 4 movie of the week. How about that?
It's earned it. You know?
It's earned it. The number 1 movie was, I never heard it. It's called My Old Ass. And it's on 7 screens and brought in $25,000 plus. All right. Beetlejuice was on 4,575 screens around the country and brought in only $11,278 on all those screens. Number 3 movie, Music for Mushrooms. Never heard of that one. On 1 screen, brought in $8,500. And in number 4, Just a Bit Outside, only on 14 screens, brought in $4,402. How about that?
So and even more good news because of that.
Thank you. Zommers, right? So it's been because of you, because of people like Zommers and everybody going out and seeing this movie, it has been extended for another week in Marcus Theaters across Wisconsin.
I'm thinking about going again.
Me too.
You know, it's a Tuesday. And the tickets are a little cheaper on Tuesdays.
Good
today
point.
Is the perfect day to go, not if you want to boost their profit, but if you want to watch it for cheaper.
But it boosts the numbers.
It does. That's
and
true.
You could give it a 5-star review if you feel so inclined. I think you will. So yeah, you're right, Sommers. Great. A Tuesday night, great time for a movie. But and also good news, I believe it's Gurnee, Illinois, where now the film has been expanded for all those Brewer fans in Cubs land. The movie's been expanded down to Illinois. Gurnee, Illinois, I believe it opens this weekend.
Gurnee Mills. Gurnee Mills Cinema in Gurnee, Illinois.
Oh, yeah. Gurnee Mills Cinema in Gurnee, Illinois. So that's great news, but at least one more weekend to get to Marcus Theaters across Wisconsin and see this great film just a bit outside, the story of the 82 Milwaukee Brewers. I'm so happy for Kelly and Sean and Paul and all those great folks who put this movie together.
Absolutely. Me too. And I'm really hoping that they end up doing a physical release or something or have it available for streaming somewhere. I know right now streaming's not in the plan.
Right.
We'll see what happens, but I would love to own it and to be able to give it as gifts to people.
Totally agree. And the best way to get it maybe to another platform is to go now to Marcus Theaters. And the better it does at the box office, the more wide the distribution. I'm no TV exec. I'm no movie expert. I'm certainly not a Hollywood insider, but I at least know that much.
Right. When there's demand, you got to increase the supply.
Exactly. Exactly right, Mr. Sommers. So there you go. So that's great news. I believe Kelly and or Sean are going to be back on the program at some point this week to talk about their success.
I hope so.
So we're looking forward to nervous anticipation to that. Coming up a little bit later on in the show, I'm going to go through and debunk, set the record straight on the latest lies by Congressman Derek Van Orten and Congressman Tom Tiffany, Republicans of Wisconsin. Really sick stuff, in my opinion. Taking advantage of one singular incident where an individual was arrested in Wisconsin and kind of in the vein of Trump and Vance using misinformation to scare people and divide people and pointed the finger at the sheriff of Dane County, Kevin Barrett. He wasn't having anything of it. He took to his official Facebook page and set the record straight. So we're going to tell you what happened. And again, if you're in the 3rd or the 7th Congressional District and you hear Van Orden and Tiffany say this crap, you'll know what actually happened and the actual truth. So we'll be diving into that a little bit later. But first, here's where I want to start. And look, it gives me no great pleasure to start here, quite frankly. Regular listeners to this show know that I grew up in Richland Center in Richland County in beautiful southwest Wisconsin, Driftless area. Proud to be from there. A great place to grow up. Some wonderful folks and wonderful things still happening in Richland County. But we were made aware yesterday of this breaking news story in Richland County, and we kind of followed it throughout the evening and want to thank people here at Civic Media, in particular Corey Hartman last night, for spending some time and going through this with me and did a lot of research and digging. And so I want to run through kind of what this story is, and then I want to give folks some practical advice, not just for Richland County, but knowing that we're a statewide show. This is an issue that most likely will affect all of us at some point in our life. And what I'm talking about is cyber attacks and identity theft.
It's happened to both of us more than once.
Yeah. It's happened to me at least twice, and it might have been a third time, where for me, it was my credit card numbers got stolen and I had to... My bank called me and said, did you buy $700 worth of meds at Walgreens? I said, no. And yeah. thankfully the credit card or the bank, whatever, they covered it. I didn't have to pay that. And I had to, but then you have to go back, you have to change everything, right? And it's a pain in the butt.
It was very similar for me where it was like, no, I did not buy like $600 worth of flowers online in Ohio.
Right. Yeah, exactly. So It's serious stuff, and so I'm going to lay this out. We're going to give you practical advice, and I want to be very careful because Again, this is still kind of a developing story out in Richland County. And I want to say off the top that I want to thank the county board chairman in Richland County, David Turk, who, in full disclosure, he and I have been colleagues in another life and worked in radio together. I've known Dave a long time. And he had the decency to call me last night as the person that he is. And I allowed him to talk a little bit on background and off the record. He also gave me an on-record statement as well. I'm going to share that with you. But my point here, as it always is to suss out the truth, to bring you what really is going on, and then to hopefully be helpful and not throw gasoline on the fire, but rather let's talk through this together and find some solutions. And again, I realize, just like the campus, right, Zomers, it starts in Richland County. I'm beginning to feel like, you know, the stereotype, Florida man, you know, Richland County man. Why does all this stuff happen in Richland County?
I don't know. I don't get it.
I don't either. But anyway, it did, and we're going to talk about it, and it's applicable, just like the campus closings in Richland County. This cyber theft in Richland County is applicable to all of us throughout the state. So here's where I'm going to start. I first heard this on Channel 3000 here in Madison. Channel 3 was covering it. I went to, Googled it up, as my old friend likes to say. And Chris Rickert, great reporter for the Wisconsin State Journal, I'm going to read a little bit of this just to give you a flavor of what happened. Richland County will provide free credit monitoring services to an undetermined number of people after revealing Monday, it says here, the article, but it was last Monday, the 9th, that the county's computer system was hacked last year, and personal information, including social security numbers, was exposed for about a month. In a statement released last week, a Michigan-based law firm working on behalf of the county said that, quote, on or about, unquote, October 4th, would have been last year, county officials, quote, detected unauthorized access to our network and immediately secured the environment and commenced a prompt, thorough investigation, unquote. Nearly 10 months later, and we're going to come back to that, nearly 10 months later, on August 1st of this year, quote, we, being the county, discovered that certain impacted files containing personal information may have been accessed and or acquired by an unauthorized individual between September 28th of 2023 and October 26th of 2023, the law firm McDonald Hopkins said. I'm going to stop there and step away from the article by Chris Rickert. I'm not sure why Richland County had to go to Michigan to get a law firm to handle this case. That's the first bad look here, by the way. We're going to come back, though, and sort through this, give you practical advice on cyber theft. Don't go anywhere. It's an important Todd Allball show. It is Tuesday, September 17th, and you're listening to the Civic Media Radio Network. Wherever it may lead, and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Todd Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. Not so much fun, at least in this hour of the show, but we are pursuing truth. Coming up in hour two, have a bit more fun. Our Go for the Green and Gold Text to Win contest. We have a new word for you coming up in hour two. And today, let me look on the old chart here. Oh, once again, we get to give away cash today.
$100.
That's very nice. $100 today. Listen, in hour two, we'll tell you exactly how to do it. But you can prepare now by downloading the Civic Media app. If you don't have it on your Apple or Android device, go to your app store. It is free. It takes less than a minute. Download it and then open it up. And we'll tell you what to do at hour two on the Civic Media app. It's as easy as texting a word, which we will give you in hour two, and you too will be eligible to win $100 this hour and then be in the drawing for the grand prize, which I have to, the lawyers tell me I can only read this a certain way. This is very important. The grand prize is, quote, a pair of indoor club-level tickets to see the Green and Gold in Green Bay Monday, December 23rd against New Orleans, unquote. And as Forrest Gump once said, and that's all I got to say about that. So yep, yep. More of that in hour two, more fun. Not so fun right now, but very, very important. Talking about this breaking news story in Richland County in southwest Wisconsin, but it's applicable to all of us across the state regarding cyber theft. So reading from this article, the Wisconsin State Journal, journalist Chris Rickert wrote this last week, actually. We just saw it yesterday, heard about it yesterday. Richland County had a cyber attack last year, last fall. It took them until this week or last week to talk about it. And now residents in Richland County over the last 48 hours or so, or plus that, are getting letters in the mail, of which I have in my hot little hands one of them right now. And the weird thing about this, and the disconcerting thing, and the confusing thing for many people in Richland County, is that it has the county logo in the upper left-hand side, but then it has a return address of Secure Processing Center in Smithtown, New York. And the letter is unsigned. It simply says, sincerely, blank space, Richland County, Wisconsin. Now, I've reached out to financial advisors, people that know a lot more about money and finance than I do, and talked to them last night and today to make sure that I'm passing on good, solid information to you. And again, this is applicable to all of us, regardless of whether we live in Richland County. The confusion is because we always talk about, right, that if you get a telephone number that you don't recognize, don't answer it. Let it go to voicemail. Don't ever give out any personal information over the phone. Don't fall for scams, basically. And this letter, understandably, because it's not signed by anyone, it looks like a scam. Unfortunately, it's not. It's real. And the Richland County Sheriff has verified this. The county board chair verified it to me last night. County administrator has verified it, that there was this cyber breach, but they didn't last year. And now there's this law firm in Michigan, McDonald Hopkins, is talking to Chris Rickert at the State Journal about it. Here's what's really scary. The law firm said, quote, the potentially impacted files contained full names, unquote, along with one or more types of personal information. Specifically, I'm going to run this down for you. I mean, people in Richland County already know this, but imagine this. Imagine if you found out that all this stuff in your life could have been compromised. It includes addresses and phone numbers, fax numbers, email addresses, dates of birth and death, social security and tax identification numbers, driver's license and government IDs, passport numbers, license plate and vehicle identification numbers, health insurance, and medical information, including prescription and biometric data, financial account information, including usernames and passwords, routing numbers and payment card numbers, expiration date, and CVV numbers. The firm representing Richland County says that it had, quote, no evidence, unquote, that any of the information that I just read has been used for identity theft or financial fraud, but was encouraging those who had personal information on file with Richland County to place fraud alerts on their credit files, get their credit reports, and remain, quote, vigilant in reviewing financial account statements and credit reports for fraudulent or irregular activity. Step away from this story here for a minute from Chris Rickert. Okay, so there's no evidence right now that this information has been used by thieves online against people in Richland County, but it doesn't mean that it couldn't be. County Administrator Candace Pesch declined, quote, for security reasons, to specify how the county computer network was affected or what county department or departments were involved. Quote, we have contacted impacted individuals directly for those that we had valid addresses, unquote. Here's the thing. I spent a lot of years in politics. In fact, I was on the Richland Center City Council for 2 terms. Never on the county board, on the city council. I worked for state officials. I worked for federal officials. I learned long ago a rule of politics, and that is, if you have a problem, hang a lantern on it. In other words, it doesn't do you any good as a government entity or an elected official to take and to keep information away from your constituents. It might be embarrassing, it might not be good news, but the best thing you could do is be transparent. Because then at least you're maintaining a sense of trust with your constituents. And the fact that the county administrator in Richland County won't tell citizens of Richland County which departments were affected is only hurting their cause. Here's why. And this is where I want to try to put some balm on this and help calm people down a little bit. Because I have to go on a guess, because people won't verify this. The only way, in my opinion, that your health insurance or medical information or prescription or biometric data could have been breached is if you gave that information to someone in the county or that, let's say you're on some sort of assistance. Let's say you're on some sort of disability. Let's say that you're an employee of Richland County. Well, then, yes, that's a possibility, keyword possibility. But if you're someone living in Richland County and you never have been one of those things, it's not like the clinic or the hospital has been breached. So I think it's really important to think for a second what your business has been with the county. I just find it upsetting that the county isn't being more transparent about this. We're going to come back. I'll tell you what the county board chair, David Turk, told me last night in a phone call. And we'll also give you practical advice, whether you're in Richland County or you anywhere else. This is great financial advice to prevent theft. Back after this on The Allball Show. Wherever it may lead, and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Tom Allball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. It is a Tuesday, September 17th, 2024. 34 minutes now, past the hour of 12 noon. Zommer's on the board. Going through this very important breaking story over the last 48 hours or so, coming out of Richland County in southwest Wisconsin. And much like the campus closure story out of southwest Wisconsin, people say, well, you're a statewide show. Why are you talking about this? Because cybersecurity is something with, if you haven't faced it, Zommers and I have, most likely all of us at some point in our lives are going to face this. And it's important that all of us be aware. I'm going to give you some great financial tips from a couple of financial advisors I've spoken to about what all of us can do in situations like this. Being prepared is critical and acting to protect all of our financial and data security, particularly financial security. So again, just to reset this, in Richland County, can we read the story from Chris Rickert of the Wisconsin State Journal from last week that Richland County, my home county, has revealed that last year, in October, they became aware that they were a victim of cybersecurity breach, their data systems. And they put out a letter to almost everyone in Richland County, or at least the great majority, to let them know this. The thing is that frustrates me is that the letter that had the Richland County letterhead on it had a return address of a place called Secure Processing Center in Smithtown, New York. And it's a form letter that was unsigned. So people in Richland County understandably thought it was just a scam. unfortunately, it's not a scam. It's real. And I went on, did some digging last night on with Corey Hartman on Secure Processing Center. And what we came up with was this place out in New York. It's kind of a bland building. Corey's kind of this, you know, he's an expert on Google Maps and Earth and Google, whatever that is. And he finds, well, this looks kind of like a weird building to me, basically a mailbox. And then we went on, did some searching online, and I have in my hands, for those watching online, I have in my hands form letters from all of the, multiple companies around the country. Here's one for Cash, or pardon me, Garda World Cash. Here's another one from Green Waste. And they all list the same return address from the Smithtown, Ohio, or pardon me, Smithtown, New York, underneath of the letterhead, just like the Richland County one. And all of these letters have various, I mean, they're basically a form letter. And so what it appears in Richland County is that whether it's this law firm that the county has hired, whether it's their insurance company, we're not exactly sure. But someone hired this secure processing center to send out a form letter in cases like this, which they've obviously done for multiple other clients who had security breaches. But unlike these other letters that were actually signed or at least had somebody's name on it, the one for Richland County that I have in my hand does not have anybody's name on it, signed. And now the county administrator, Candace Pesch, won't tell people, won't tell the press, won't tell clients, won't tell taxpayers which department or departments in Richland County were involved. Pesch, according to Rickert's story in the State Journal, Pesch deferred other questions, including how many people had their information compromised and how many people are getting credit monitoring to McDaniel Hopkins, their out-of-state lawyer out in Michigan, which did not immediately respond last week to request for comment to the Wisconsin State Journal. So this is frustrating to me as someone who grew up there and still has family and friends there. And I don't understand yet why there's this lack of transparency and information to county residents. I talked to our colleagues at WRCO, my old station, now part of Civic Media. No one had contacted them. And anybody that lives in Richland County knows there's one place, if you want to get information out to the public, it's WRCO in Richland Center, WRCO, WRCE. And no one had contacted them prior. Now, last night, the county put out a statement. And I'm not going to, it's a lengthy page, a little page plus. And look, I worked in politics a long time. This is nothing more than a cover your posterior letter. It doesn't say anything different, basically, than the letters that they sent out. And gives this toll-free, out-of-state number to call if you have questions. More importantly, I reached out to Richland County Board Chair Dave Turk last night. And again, under full disclosure, I used to work with Dave in the radio station there. I've known him a long time. So it's a bit uncomfortable, quite frankly. But he was very gracious with his time. He called me back. Because I wanted to understand this and report this correctly, I gave him the opportunity to speak off the record and on background. What that off the record means, if someone tells you something off the record, you cannot use that information. If they talk on background, you could use it generally, but you don't attribute it. And then there's on the record, which is the statement that I have. And honestly, I really didn't learn a whole lot off of record on background any more than I know. So it's not like I was told some big secret off the record and I'm withholding it from you. I'm not. It was, and here's the statement that Dave Turk, County Board Chair of Richland County, gave me last night. He said, quote, "I understand why people are concerned and confused, and I share a lot of those concerns," unquote. That's as much as I can say on the record, directly attributed to Chairman Turk. He was gracious with his time. My sense is, I will tell you that he is very frustrated with the situation. And remember, he was not the county board chair when all this occurred last year. He just became chair earlier this year. I don't know the exact timing of the county administrator, but I understand that she is newer too. But I think there is a lot of frustration by this lack of transparency. If I were still living in Richland Center, Richland County, I'd be demanding answers from my county board supervisor and the county board in general. That's the thing that, as an elected person, that always catches up, right? It's the lack of transparency. So there are a lot of good people here involved, but again, there's a lot of frustration as well. The county board chair certainly shares that frustration. Let me give you some good practical advice here, because I reached out to, because it's not just about identifying problems, right? It's about solutions, about providing good information. So I reached out to some financial advisors, people that know a lot more about this stuff than me. And this is where it becomes a good issue for all of us. Not a good issue, but you know what I'm saying. A valuable piece of information. Because whether you live in Richland County now or whether you live in Green Bay or Amory or Waukesha, all of us are vulnerable to having our identity stolen and cybersecurity. Our computers get breached. How many times have we heard, like, if you don't know who that email is from, don't open it up, and certainly don't click on any links in it. Because once people get into your computer, then, you know, there you go. So this is good for anybody, but particularly right now for people in Richland County. Here's what you can do according to the financial advisors that I talked with. There are kind of two levels, and the letter that Richland County sent out also says this, in fairness. So there are kind of two levels that you can do. If you got one of these letters in Richland County, or if you feel you've ever been or in the future are about to be a victim of theft, or you want to protect yourself, here's how you can protect yourself before you get your stuff stolen. There are two levels. First of all, you can place what's called a fraud alert on your credit file. All right? And it's an initial one-year fraud alert on your credit file. There is no charge for that. But here's the thing. You have to. There are three main credit companies out there. Like when you go, let's say you go to Best Buy and they have 0% interest on a new TV and you say, yeah, I want to do that over 2 years. Well, they're going to run your credit report. Obviously, if you buy a new car, if you get a house, anytime that you get a credit report, I used to work at L.L. Bean. We did, you know, L.L. Bean cards. By the way, it's a great card. But no, you run a credit report, right? You have to fill something out on an iPad, and they tell you whether you qualify. Well, they're either checking with one of three companies, Equifax, Experian, or TransUnion. And so to do a fraud alert, you have to call, and there's numbers on these letters, and we can put it in our show notes, Summers. I'll give it to you. And if it's a fraud alert, you just call one of these companies and they share all that information. And basically, it's like two-step verification, like when you, I don't know, like if you have my chart for your health stuff. And they say, well, you log in and then it says, we'll send you a number to your cell phone or your email to two-step authentication. Some companies do that. And that's basically what this is for your credit. So if you do the credit, the fraud alert, you just call one of these, Equifax, Experian, or TransUnion, and that does it for all of them. And then if you go to Best Buy or you go to your local hardware store or whatever, I don't know, new car or buy a car, if you run your credit, they're going to call you or text you to make sure that it's you. And then they'll lift that fraud alert. The more difficult one, or not difficult, but just a little bit more timely, but the more secure one is to place a security freeze on your credit freeze on your credit. And there's also no charge for that. But in the credit freeze, you have to call each one of these, all three of them, Equifax Security, Experian Security, and TransUnion Security. You have to call all of those, and that's a hard freeze on your credit. Now, the advisors I spoke with said that's more for people who you're in a position in your life. It might be a retired person or it might not. But your car, your vehicle is paid for, your house is paid for. You're probably not going to be applying for new credit cards anytime soon. Basically, you kind of work with cash and the one credit card or two that you might have, and you're not going to be applying for new credit. If that's you, you might want to consider doing the credit freeze. Because on that one, if anybody tries to run anything in your name, including you, then they're going to go to you and you have to lift that, you have to call them and lift that credit freeze to buy something, or not to buy, but to do a, to apply for credit. I know this is a little fuzzy, but the most secure one is the credit freeze. And the next one that's a little easier is the fraud alert. So if you receive one of these letters from Richland County, I would do one of the other of those. Also, the credit advisors I spoke to said that any of us across Wisconsin, just healthy, at least once a year, we should get a free credit report. I'm going to give you a toll-free number to call. We can also put this on. I'll give it to you later. We'll post it a website. Here is the number to call to get a free credit report. 877-322-8228. I'll repeat it. Toll-free number to get a free credit report annually, 877-322-8228. You can also go to annualcreditreport.com, annualcreditreport.com. Everybody, all of us should know this. I do this periodically. Look at your credit report. You might be surprised what's on there. And then go to your local financial institution, your banker, your credit union, what have you, and have them walk you through that. So those are the biggest things you could do if you're concerned, to give yourself a little ease of mind. Have you ever been victim of credit theft? 855-752-4842. Would love to hear from you, whether you're in Richland County or somewhere else. What has been your experience with credit or identity theft? 855-752-4842. 855-752-4842. Would love to hear from you. Talking about credit and identity theft. Pursuing truth wherever it may lead and having fun doing it. Welcome back to the Tunnel Ball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. Have you ever had your identity stolen? Not like you're on the street and somebody says, "Are you Bill?" "Oh, I'm sorry, no, I'm Todd." Not like that kind of identity, but like, has anybody ever hacked you electronically? Has anybody ever stolen your credit card number? Zomer and I both have had that happen. And it can be embarrassing, right? Sometimes. Like, oh, man.
Somebody... Depending on what it's used for and how it gets stolen.
Right. But we all have, or most likely, unfortunately, will experience credit theft, identity theft. So, again, we're still learning some of this stuff in Richland County. And here's the frustrating part. When the county isn't transparent with its constituents, then, and I'm not even delving into this, right? There's local rumors and rants pages, and then that's just a cesspool. You know, there's all, and you don't know what's fact and what's fiction. And then rumors, like, it's like mushrooms in a dark closet. They begin to grow and just, you have no idea what's truthful and what's not. And that's unhealthy. So I know there's going to be a county board meeting tonight in Richland County. We are told that they are not going to take public comment tonight because there was already a lengthy meeting of pre-scheduled things, and they are going to take comments next week on this from the public in Richland County. But here's, I mean, and this is the confusing part too. It literally says in this story by Chris Rickert from last week in the State Journal, Richland County will provide free credit monitoring services to an undetermined number of people. And the financial people that I talked with who are from this, let me make this point. What happened in Richland County is not uncommon. So it's not like, oh my gosh, you know, this is, Richland County's terrible because this happened to them. No. There's, I think there was a story in Rock County recently. There's been other places in Wisconsin. This happens, unfortunately, every day around the world. And in most cases of the financial people that I talked to, they said it's most of the companies or government entities to which this happens, they pay for this free credit monitoring service. Not just the one-time free credit report, but like a year or two where they'll pay for whatever it is, a monthly or annual fee of $39.99 or whatever it is, where you continually monitor your credit. And Richland County's lawyers are telling the press that it will do that. But what makes Richland County's letter, which I have in my hand, unique, is that they don't give any direction of how they're going to provide that in Richland County, and the county administrator won't tell the press how many citizens it will pay for that credit monitoring service for. So lots of unanswered questions. But let me just reiterate that all of us across the state of Wisconsin, if you want to protect yourself in today's world, the easiest thing to do is contact one of these, Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion, and put on a credit fraud alert. And that means that in order to get credit for anything, you're going to have to lift that fraud alert. The absolute more secure way is to put a credit freeze on your credit file. But for that one, you have to call each one of those three companies. With a credit fraud alert, you just call one. And again, maybe talk to your financial advisor, talk it over, because it is a bit of a, you know, if you're someone's like, well, you know, I do buy things on credit and I know I'm going to have to buy a new car within the year. I know I'm going to have to get new furniture. I'm going to take credit out on. If that's the way you live and, you know, no judgment, then the freeze might not be for you. But if you're someone who is more set financially and you're not going to get a lot of credit, you're not going to apply for a lot of credit, then the freeze might be a way for you to go. Again, this is not, I have to cover myself, right? I'm not giving out legal advice for you specifically. I'm just passing on information that respected people in the financial world have told me about what we should all do. And also I'm repeating what's on these letters in Richland County. Have you ever been a victim of credit fraud? 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. Let's go to the text line, listening on WXCO in beautiful Wausau. Tony on Wausau says, great timely information. Just went through this with a healthcare payment processor. Form letter, very confusing and worth a Google to see if the breach is real. Offered free credit monitoring, see? And Googled that too before signing up.
One thing that's also recommended, if you receive a phone call telling you about this, don't give them information.
100%.
Call them back at a number you know to be official. For example, if your credit card, if someone's calling about that, there's a number on the back of it you can call.
Right. Or this letter that we know to be real, Richland County, the number that they're giving you. But I've heard people have called it, and basically you just get an out-of-state number, you get an attorney, which is not particularly helpful.
Not really.
No. Also, Matt listing in Germantown, WAUK in Waukesha says, look into your employee benefits. My employer has credit monitoring as a benefit. That's a couple of dollars a month. And also has insurance if someone did steal my card. Wow. That's awesome, Matt. And props to your employer. I don't know I've ever heard an employer offering credit monitoring as a benefit. That's super cool.
I guess it depends where you work.
Yeah. Well, that's what a great benefit. Because it's out there. And again, I don't want to call it a sin, but the sin isn't that this happened in Richland County. The frustrating part is the lack of transparency. And a reminder, we don't know all the information yet. We don't know who's making these decisions because unfortunately they haven't told us. Is it Richland County, the elected officials and the administrator who are making these decisions? Is it the attorney? Is it an insurance company? Who's making these decisions? That would be helpful for the public to know that. All right. But again, the county board chair says that he is as frustrated as anyone and shares people's concerns. I thought that was an important story just to bring people, because again, in these types of situations, you're going to hear, this is where social media is not particularly helpful, because you're going to hear all of these rumors and innuendos that we're just not going to dive into. But the baseline is protect your financial integrity by either putting a fraud alert or a credit freeze on your credit. Going to come back, have some fun in hour two. The Go for the Green and Gold Text to Win contest. We're giving away cold, hard cash in hour two. Also debunking Derek Van Orten and Tom Tiffany. It's the Todd Allbowl Show for a Tuesday, and you're listening to the Civic Media Radio Network.